Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're talking about cryptocurrency. We're talking about the future of cryptocurrency, and I want to share with you something that I'm concerned about that not very many people are talking about. I'm going to build a case for you, and then I'm going to tell you what I feel like we need to do as cryptocurrency investors to protect ourselves, particularly in the DeFi space. This is incredibly important if you're in the DeFi space. Something that I want you to know about me is I always invest defensively, meaning I take risk, I understand my risk, but in the back of my mind, I'm always thinking, what if this goes wrong? Today, I'm thinking about that when it comes to Bitcoin. You see, I've been optimistic that Bitcoin price would hit $100,000 or more this year. And I said at the beginning of the year, when I put out that video, I said one of the things that I think could stop it would be coming regulations that we don't currently see, some sort of very strict regulations, particularly here in the US. That's not materialized yet, and that's a good thing. However, something else has recently started and it's gotten me concerned. And I think this one thing could affect the price of Bitcoin negatively more than anything else. And nobody is drawing this correlation, particularly in the cryptocurrency space. So I want to tell you all about it, and I want to tell you how I'm planning to protect myself. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Crypto Wealth. I believe in cryptocurrency. I believe in this technology, and I believe this technology is the future of finance. If you believe in that, do me a favor and smash that like button. If you like cryptocurrency and you love earning passive income in cryptocurrency, do me a favor and hit that subscribe button. Bitcoin's over $37,000. I think this is incredible. People are always calling the end of Bitcoin. You hear all these people charting, oh, we see support here. Oh, we see, you know, we see resistance here. And then Bitcoin keeps breaking through every price level or dropping below every price level. These technical analysis guys, they're laughable to watch. I wish they would put lines on their videos and you could go back. In fact, I personally have done that. I have watched some of the biggest names in YouTube draw lines on charts. I went back and looked at their videos and was like, yeah, that didn't work. I would say that they're accurate about 50% of the time, which means you and I could flip a coin and be accurate as well. But I think what's most important is understanding what are the fundamental factors that are pushing cryptocurrency forward or pulling it backwards. And there's something going on right now that very few people are talking about, and I want to share it with you right now, and that is inflation. Inflation is coming. Now, this is ironic because Bitcoin is created at its core because the creators were worried about our current economic system ultimately having a lot of inflation in it. Now, inflation is really bad. You see, the US dollar is the only asset that you can own that your government can actually take the value of that dollar away. You see, inflation averages somewhere like 3% a year. And if you think about that, in 10 years, your dollars buy 30% less. It's more than that because it's actually compound interest against you. It's compounded to the negative, meaning that you can still have $100, but they will no longer buy, you know, $100 worth of food, for example. They'll buy $70 worth of food if the value of your dollar gets inflated. This is really not that big of a problem most of the time. In most environments, when 1, 2, 3% inflation, you actually don't realize it. You don't feel it. You don't actually know that it happens. But if it starts to pick up speed and it happens really, really fast, that's when there's a potential problem. And I think this is actually going to have a negative effect on Bitcoin. But first, let me show you what's going on in case you don't know this, because there's not a lot of coverage on this. Not nearly as much as I felt there should be. CoinDesk says U.S. consumer prices rise faster than expected. Now, the reason I think this is important is because it points out the fact that most people were wrong. Most of the talking heads, most of the pundits said, oh, you know, we're not going to have a lot of inflation. Yes, we're going to start handing out stimulus checks because of this worldwide health crisis we got going on. But don't worry, it's not going to cause inflation. Now, those of you that watch my channel, you know that I said that I didn't even understand how that made logical sense. Look, I don't have a MBA and I'm not a Harvard graduate, but if you print more of something, it creates inflation. If you have a cryptocurrency where they are printing a large supply and they're adding to the supply all the time, then inflation is in effect. Now the question is, do you feel the inflation or not? But they said, you know, they didn't expect it to be that big a deal. So this news story is incredible because clearly U.S. consumer prices rise faster than expected. And by the way, that's essentially what inflation is. Prices go up and they go up faster than wages. So that creates inflation. It means that you don't have enough dollars. What it comes down to is the average person doesn't have enough money to buy the things that they need or to possibly pay their bills if it's, you know, was too bad. Now, let's take a look at this news story. Hot inflation may have become scorching in May and is expected to hit a 28-year high. So I think this is incredible. A 28-year high. You would think this is newsworthy. You'd think people are paying attention to this, but they're not. So I'm telling you about this ahead of time. By the way, I don't have a crystal ball. I could be proven wrong, but I don't think that I am going to be. Hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification icon. Let's stay here together on this journey. I'm not giving you this information just to create random content. This is the kind of thing that I'm very passionate about. You see, I'm in the cryptocurrency space because I believe fundamentally in what it's capable of doing. And it's these sort of policies which are exactly why Bitcoin was originally created in the first place. Now, I understand that if we get here early on this technology and we invest wisely, then we have the chance to be able to become very wealthy as individuals. That's a real possibility. But I also understand that you have to recognize that when the worst thing that you can do for your cryptocurrency bag is sell your crypto when the prices go down. Meaning if you sell because you've lost value, then you're selling at a loss in many cases. So you don't ever want to have to sell at a loss. So it's important that you understand this is coming so you can plan accordingly because the worst thing that you want to do is put yourself in a situation where you're forced to sell at a loss. Ladies and gentlemen, what I'm telling you, I believe inflation is coming. What I'm telling you, if you're in a position where you're living paycheck to paycheck right now on your job, then you need to understand that it's very possible that it's going to become much more difficult to pay your bills coming forward. And if you're investing in cryptocurrency, recognize that the current prices may be going down. Now, I know you're saying, but Wealth, aren't you saying inflation was why this is created? Yes, but I'll get to that, so please bear with me. Inflation is higher than expected, but it looks temporary, they said, and likely won't affect Fed policy. See, this right here, the longer it takes the Federal Reserve is supposed to, what they're supposed to do is raise interest rates. And when they raise interest rates, what it should do, essentially, is it should slow down price increases. It basically pulls money out of the economy. Now, if that sounds like a bad thing, it does have a negative effect on the average person. What I'm telling you is either way you look at it, the economy is about to slow down or the economy is going to heat up. But your ability to buy goods and services, and when I say your, I mean the average person to buy goods and services, is going to go down. Hear me on this. The average person, people are not talking about this. I want you to be prepared for this because I don't believe this is all negative as long as you're not caught off by surprise. But for the average person to use their paycheck and go buy groceries, go buy food, go pay rent, you know, pay bills, buy a house, whatever, their ability to do that is going to go down for one of two reasons. Either inflation will kick in and get out of control and they're just not making enough dollars because prices go up faster than wages, or a lot of people are going to have a hard time getting a job because the economy is going to slow down. Anytime the Fed increases interest rates, it often slows down the economy a little bit. And we're not in an environment right now where we really want to see the economy slowing down because of inflation. The Fed is in a catch-22 where they're like, which pill is going to be harder to swallow? This headline I thought was interesting. Inflation is hotter than expected. Again, proves that they were wrong, but it looks temporary. Now, come on. Anytime you see the word but, you erase everything in front of it because it doesn't make sense that you say inflation's worse than we expected, but it's only temporary. Well, you were wrong once. How are you suddenly right this time? And likely won't affect Fed policy. And I think that's most dangerous of all. Now, where are we getting reports about inflation? One reputable source just put out a scathing report, Deutsche Bank, and I'm going to read through this because this is not that long, but this report is incredible. And then I'm going to talk about why I think it's going to have a negative impact. Because see, long term, I think inflationary policies are ultimately good for cryptocurrency, particularly Bitcoin, which is going to be used as a currency. That's its fundamental purpose. In the short term, I think it hurts the price of cryptocurrencies. Let's look at this first. Deutsche Bank issues a dire economic warning for America. As the world economy awakens from the 15-month slumber caused by the pandemic, Deutsche Bank launches a series of research articles to spark debate and discussion about pressing post-pandemic economic issues. On June 7th, Deutsche Bank issued its first report of the new series titled Inflation, the defining macro story of this decade. If that's not an ominous headline, I don't know what is. According to the report, U.S. macro policy and indeed the very role of government in the economy is undergoing its biggest shift in direction in 40 years. In turn, we are concerned that it will bring about uncomfortable levels of inflation. That could be deemed an understatement considering that the U.S. economy is already experiencing uncomfortable inflation. Considered based on the most recent inflation report from the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics in April, the Consumer Price Index for all urban consumers rose 0.8% on a seasonally adjusted basis, rising 4.2% over the last 12 months. That's way higher than 3%, by the way, 4.2%. An annual inflation rate of 4.2% is more than uncomfortable, but the looming threat of inflation seems to have fallen on deaf ears in Washington, D.C. over the past year, as Congress has supercharged spending to levels unseen since World War II. You see, Congress keeps passing stimulus. They keep giving out more money, but they don't have the money, so they print it. And when you print it, it's like printing unlimited amounts of a cryptocurrency. Eventually, the price just goes down. As Deutsche Bank notes, the current fiscal stimulus is more comparable with that seen around World War II. Then, U.S. deficits remain between 15 to 30% for 4 years. While there are many significant differences between the pandemic and World War II, we would note that the annual inflation was 8.4% to 14.6% and 7.7% in 1946, 1947, and 1948 after the economy normalized and pent-up demand was released. If the U.S. economy descends into an inflation spiral like that experienced after World War II, we could be on the brink of excruciating economic pain. And that's what I want you to understand. That's incredible, Bob. This is in their official report. They actually use this. This isn't some media term that's just trying to be sensational. Excruciating economic pain. What do you think most people are going to do if they're in excruciating economic pain? Do you think they're going to invest? Or you think they're going to cash in on investment? Are you picking up what I'm putting down? Profligate spending by Congress is only part of the problem. According to Deutsche Bank, monetary stimulus has been equally breathtaking. In numerical terms, the Fed's balance sheet has almost doubled during the pandemic to nearly $8 trillion. The deficit, our debt has nearly doubled. That's nuts. That compares with the 2008 crisis when it only increased by a little more than $1 trillion. Think about that. $1 trillion to $8 trillion, and then increased another $2 trillion in the subsequent 6 years. So it took 6 years to go from $1 trillion to $2 trillion. And in 18 months, we double it to $8 trillion. As an economist will tell you, printing gobs of money over a short period of time, which is what the Federal Reserve has done during the is a key inflation ingredient. We've seen this happen many times over the past century, from Weimar Germany to present-day Venezuela. Massive money printing never works and always spurs out-of-control inflation. The Deutsche Bank report concludes with the dire warning, "We worry that inflation will make a comeback. Few still remember how our societies and economies were threatened by high inflation 50 years ago. The most basic laws of economics, the ones that have stood the test of time over a millennium, have not been suspended. An explosive growth in debt, financed largely by central banks, is likely to lead to higher inflation. Rising prices will touch everyone. The effects could be devastating, particularly for the most vulnerable in society." Sadly, when central banks do act at this stage, they will be forced into abrupt policy change, which will make it harder for policymakers to achieve the social goals that our societies need. As mentioned above, the German people are well aware of that skyrocketing inflation, and in and of itself can spark more than just economic upheaval. Hyperinflation like that experienced in post-World War I Germany can also lead to social disorder and political chaos. In fact, one of the reasons, this is huge, ladies and gentlemen, one of the reasons Adolf Hitler and the Nazi Party came to power in Weimar Germany was the public's resentment concerning hyperinflation they suffered as a result of endless money printing by Germany's central bank in the 1920s to pay off the World War I repatriations. Of course, the rise of Hitler was not solely due to hyperinflation in Weimar Germany, but when out-of-control inflation takes hold, people reasonably panic. Throughout history, we've seen inflation-spurred panic manifest in social, political, and economic turmoil. The looming question is how Americans will deal with the strong possibility of a post-inflation environment, the likes of which could be unprecedented in our nation's history. So this is incredible. This is an article by The Hill where they were commenting on this report by Deutsche Bank. And I don't think most people prepared for this. So I think most people in crypto are not here. The vast majority are not here because of some sort of store of value. The vast majority of people are here because they're looking to make gains. They're speculating. Specifically, if you're yield farming in high-risk yield farms, most people are here speculating. And when they need money, they're going to cash in, which means Bitcoin's going to go down, Ethereum's going to go down, the whole market could go down if we see this inflation, which I genuinely believe is coming. Look, I actually think it's already here. We're just not feeling it right now. I mean, they've already printed money. Inflation's here. We're on track to have 4.5% inflation, which is 50% larger than the goal of 3%. I mean, in 10 years, if you have 3% inflation, the value of your dollars drop by 30%. In 10 years, if you have 4.5% inflation, the value of your dollar drops to almost 50%. That is significant, meaning your dollars buy less. Your wages are not going to keep up with that. Here's my advice. And by the way, this is financial advice. You just shouldn't take financial advice from a YouTuber. So you can, you know, this advice is probably as valuable as toilet paper, but still, I highly recommend that you start making decisions now to kind of shore up your finances. If you have a bill, if you have a bill that's, you know, $100 a month or a couple hundred dollars a month and you have a way to pay it off, I recommend that you pay it off. Even if you have to use, you know, gains you've made in the market or gains you've used in crypto to pay it off, I recommend you pay it off, because it's easier not to worry about a bill that's costing you a couple hundred dollars a month than it is to have to figure out how you can make that extra couple hundred dollars a month when you're already tight on your finances. I would not encourage you to take unnecessary risk in crypto. I'm not telling you not to get into the space. I'm not telling you not to invest. But listen, my videos, I talk about yield farming. If I'm going to be honest with you, I talk about it because it's interesting. I talk about it because I think long term there's some bigger use cases here. But the real reason I talk about it is because people want to know about it. Anytime you can tell somebody a way they can make some money, they want to know about it. But at the end of the day, you have to be careful. If you're already living check to check, now's not the time to start trying out a hot new yield farming strategy. Someone in one of my comments said, "I don't have a lot of money. How can I do this?" If you don't have a lot of money, you just got to short what you got going on, because things might get tight. The last thing you need to do is be buying into Bitcoin if we're going to have strong inflation. So you need to be careful, ladies and gentlemen. Be cautious. I believe the greatest threat to the price of cryptocurrency right now is not government regulations. At this very moment, I think the greatest threat is quick inflation, short-term or longer-term inflation. It's inflation. People are going to cash out their Bitcoin. They're going to cash out their gains. They're going to cash out their cryptocurrency. Heck, they'll cash it out for a loss, which could, if a lot of people start cashing out for a loss because they need the money, it could cause the price of Bitcoin to drop significantly. So when I'm trading Bitcoin, my trading strategies all are designed to be able to handle a 60% drop in the price of Bitcoin. But I can tell you right now, I'm planning for potentially further than a 60% drop in Bitcoin, because I think that inflation could be the catalyst. I hope it's not. I'm still biased on Bitcoin going up. I still trade directionally as Bitcoin's going up, because I trade on with a longer term, and I trade on short-term time frames, but with a long-term mindset. But I'm also aware that if this inflation kicks in the way that it's looking like, and nobody's talking about this, by the time everybody starts talking about it, it could be too late. So make plans now. Protect yourself, protect your future, protect your finances. Cryptocurrency is incredible, ladies and gentlemen. I want you to learn about this technology. I want you to love this technology and be as passionate about it as I am. But first and foremost, we have to take care of our families and protect ourselves and our households. Decentralized cryptocurrency equals freedom. Centralized governments cause inflation. This is Crypto Wealth. I'm out.